Hi, and welcome to a new section of our course. In this section, we'll talk about diff and managing conflicts. We will start understanding the diff format. Then we will generate a conflict, and we will use the diff tree format to better understand how to solve this conflict. After this, we will see how we can do a diff between the working copy and the stage area, or the working copy and the last commit. At the end of this section, we will see how we can generate a diff for a single file. Let's start with our first video. In this video, we'll talk about the diff file format. We will generate some changes and we will understand the diff file format. As always, we are inside our working copy and we are on the develop branch. Let's suppose that we need to do some changes on the index.html file. So we need to change the word conquering to master. And as well here below, instead of conquering, we say master. We check the current state of the repository. And we can add this file to the index and generate a commit. How can we now compare the difference between the current commit, that is head, and the previous commit, that is head minus one? The command is a simple git diff, and then the two identifiers. The result is in a specific format that is called the diff format. It's basically the same as the output of the diff tool by itself, but in this case, it's used inside Git. Let's check this output line by line. So the first line starts with the diff minus minus git. Minus minus git is not a real option to the diff tool. This is just an information that this output was generated not calling the diff tool by itself, but using a git instead. Then we have the two files that we are comparing. In this case, we are not really comparing two different files, but we are comparing the same file into different commits. For this reason, Git generated two kind of a fake folder, the folder A and the folder B. So the diff tool can show us the difference between these two versions of the same file. The second line contains some internal information. This is the ID of the index file in the head minus one and the ID of the index file into the head commit. But this is really not an information that we need to know. Then we have the file mode. In case we change a file from being a normal file to be an executable file, or from being a normal file to a symlink file, in that case, we will also see here a difference in the file mode. Then we have these two lines. The first line starts with minus, 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 and the second one starts with plus, plus, plus. The meaning of these two lines is that when you find a minus into the diff file format, then it's referred to the a/index.html, that is the head minus one version of the file. And when you find a plus, this is referred to the b/index.html file, that is the file in the head commit. Now we can finally see the real difference in this file. All the differences appear with a bit of context. So the real difference is on this line. So this line was conquering Git on the file minus, that was the a/index, that was head minus one. And then it was on the file plus, that is head, was converted to master git. But showing only the change can be a little bit confusing. So diff give us a little bit of context about where this line is inside the file. So we have two lines above and two lines below to give us a little bit of context. If this is not enough, we also have this information here that give us the information where this snippet of code can be found in the original file. And what this strange number means that we are looking at a 7-line snippet of code, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So we are looking at the 7-line snippet of code starting from line 8 in the file minus. As well on the file plus, that is the file on the head commit, we are looking at the 7-line snippet of code starting on line 8. And as well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So now we have all the information that we need to really understand this diff file.